Hey there, Josephine from eMarketeer here, and in this video, I would like to show you how you can use the campaign reports in eMarketeer. So I'm gonna go straight to it. There are a couple of different reporting widgets that you can use to track your campaigns. So in this video, I'm gonna go over the funnel chart, the goal gauge, and the KPI counter. So the funnel chart works well for like an event or a lead nurture flow because this funnel chart works as like a marketing funnel where we start off broad from the beginning, but then for each step in the journey, we see people that either convert to the next step or drop off. And that's visualized in the funnel chart. So I'm going to show you an example. I'm going to stick with the event example for this one. So here is my very brief event campaign where I have the event invitation, an email, the sign up form to the event, and then an attendee form that can be used at the actual event. So I add campaign reporting, I choose the funnel chart widget, and here I choose the steps that I want to track in my funnel. So they have to be in the right order. So the first one here is my email invitation. And here I have a couple of different actions to choose from. I have sent, delivered, opened, or clicked. So here I actually want to see how many people actually got my invitation. So I choose delivered. But in the next one, I want to see how many people actually opened it. So here I have the same component, but a different action. Next step, I want to see how many people actually sign up for my event. So sign up. And how many submitted that form. And let's say that I have this attendee form at the actual event where I scan the guests' barcodes when they arrive so I can keep track of how many people actually show up. So let's choose submitted here as well. And in this example, the event already happened, so I have some data there in the last step. So here I have my funnel where I have the conversion rate between each step here, as you can see, but I also have the overall conversion rate. So from the very first step to the very last step. These bars, they're also clickable. So when I click them, I get a selection of contacts that did this step or that didn't, depending on where I click on the bar here. An important thing to note here, though, is that for a contact to be counted in these bars, they have to have performed the step right before. So for a contact to be counted in this green bar, they have to have done this light blue bar step as well. If I mouse over the components' names here, right below the bar, I can click them and get straight to that components report as well. So the goal gauge is for when you have a specific number as a goal and you want to follow how close you are to reaching that target. So for example, if you have set that you want 20 downloads of a white paper or 10 signups for a webinar, it could look a little something like this. Here I have a campaign for a white paper where people can fill out this form on my website to receive a white paper. And that's what I want to track. Add campaign reporting, choose goal gauge. And I choose my component, which was the white paper download form. I'm going to submit it. And here I set my target, which is 250. And here I can see how close I am to reaching that target, both in this progress bar here, but also as a percentage right below it. And I can also change the color here of it if I'd like. The KPI counter works very similar to the goal gauge, but the difference here is that it's a counter, so you don't set a specific target. So it could be useful, for example, for newsletter subscribers. So I click my KPI counter. I choose the form that people fill out to sign up for my newsletter. And it's as simple as that. Now it counts how many people signed up to receive my newsletters. And as you can see, here I have some room to add some more charts as well, because these different types of charts or widgets, they can be used separately as I've done in these examples, but you can also mix and match. So let's go back to my event example where I have the funnel chart, but let's say that I want to add the goal gauge and the KPI here as well. So I go in here to the funnel chart because I have to make it a bit smaller so I get some room for my other charts. There. Add campaign reporting. The goal gauge, and let's say that I want 15 signups for my event. And lastly, I want to count how many people show up to my event. There you have it. Now have fun measuring your campaigns. I hope they're all a big success, and I will see you next time.